Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to implement RLS or row level security in parent-child hierarchy. If you're not sure what is a parent-child hierarchy, you can have a look at it. You have employee information and you have another column called manager, where the employee Banu reports to 102, which is nothing but Naga. Let's take another example. 101 Vino is reporting to 105, and 105 Karthik reports to Naga again. So this is the parent child hierarchy data. So how to implement RLS for it? Basically, when a user logs in, assume this user logs in, he should say his own data along with the members below him, right? So whoever reports him. So basically Karthik logs in, he should see Suman as well as Vinod, and along with these people reporters as well. You can see if someone else, let's say Ruth is reporting to Suman, he should also see this. In this case, everyone reports to Karthik. So this is what the parent-child hierarchy is and how you can implement this in Power BI. That is what we are going to see. To help us with to implement this requirement, the two DAX functions will be so useful, that is path and path contains. Let's try to understand how it helps us. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's try to view the data once again. So this is our data. Now, as I said before, we have employee data and we have our sales, right? We can quickly check the model here. Sales and employee. This is related to employee ID. Now, when an employee logs in, he should see his own data along with the members below him. As we said, when Karthik logs in, he should see his data along with the members he reports him. So, how you can find this one, right? How you can understand how the hierarchy members, right, under him. So you need to create one new column for that employee based on this. So the path is the function path, employee ID and manager ID. When you give this, it will give you the hierarchical path and it will have all its reporting persons starting from the leaf level. So he's the Ruth is the leaf level, and Ruth manager is 108, which is Suman, and Suman manager is 105, it's Karthik. Karthik's manager is Naga. So like this, it will keep on going the entire hierarchy. So our task is to search in this hierarchy. When Karthik logs in, we will get his ID and we will check whether 105 is present in his part. That's it. So this is the two steps we are going to do. The first step is to create this hierarchy that is using a path function, and the next step where we are going to create is like in the model. I mean, it's not in the modeling tab, like manage roles. In the manage roles, employee path contains. So let me explain what it is. So the path contains takes the employee hierarchy, which is nothing but the path field, and this usually takes the single argument like who is that employee ID. In order to get the Karthik employee ID when he logs in, so we are filtering his email ID as soon as he logs in from the employee table and gets his ID. So that ID passed in the path contains. So this hierarchy searches, I mean, this is the hierarchical column, right? It contains 101, 105 for each row. It will search for Karthik ID 105. If it returns true, then that particular record will be filtered here. Then he will see his records. That is what it is. So that is the logic behind it. Let's try to test as soon as Karthik logs in. So when Karthik logs in, karth at abc.com, that's it. So he can see he is the, these two people are direct reporters to Karthik. Karthik, Suman, Vinod, Ruth is reporting to Suman. So that is how it is. So I hope you understand how you can implement RLS for parent-child hierarchies using two simple functions, path and path contents. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.